What makes Framed great? Why, it's kids. Dogs. And, of course, trampolines. Coming up, everything you need to know for the perfect framed clip. It's the You've Been Framed guide to You've Been Framed. Welcome to the show. Since the financial crash, this is how the head of HBOS now gets to work. He's paraded through streets flooded with the tears of investors. And then, when he reaches the offices, he's dropped off. Serves him right. Luckily, I had all my money in scratch cards. Water's great for Framed because it's wet. Under these concrete slabs are members of Labour's shadow cabinet.
Step on one.
Ed Miliband, Ed Balls, and I think... yep, that's Diane Abbott.
Oh, I got that on video.
Skateboards. Yes, we love a mirror Framed, particularly when combined with steps. But he can still move his legs anyway.
Hi.
Overconfident kids, usually American, yes. Especially when spiced up with a little sibling rivalry. Dogs, yes, with balls, even better. Although we'll take the castrated type too.
Shoot it, Coleman.
Hey, ride him, cowboy. Crossing water of any kind is perfect for us, even a tiny stream like this. It's actually just down the road from Highgrove House, and Camilla's popped down the shops and left the bath running. Anything with Bono in, we'll buy. And on a trampoline, where do we sign? Framed wouldn't be framed without music. Carefully chosen, of course.
The city blacks out the sun, but you know it's rising.
Dogs plus cameras can put money in your bank. Dogs and water are a classic combination. Ipswich Council are keen to stop dogs fouling their parks, but their latest method has caused controversy. Eight Shih Tzus, a Dachshund and a pensioner are still missing. It's curling with Labradors. Not yet officially recognised by the Olympic Committee, but we're trying.
How'd you make out?
Lovely one.
He's a bit big to be using the slide, and if it's wet, there's every chance you'll get stuck. And if there's a dog, well... it's almost like a play within a play, isn't it? Sibling rivalry again. Works throughout the animal kingdom.
Ah, oh,
the exercise treadmill, absolute goldmine. You can see the weight falling off him. That's why his trousers keep falling down. Naturally, the dog wants to join in. Someone take him out for a walk. Lloyd Grossman lying spark out after a particularly grueling episode of Through the Keyhole. As you can see, he's had a bowl of egg-fried rice and collapsed. The dog's worried that he's left the gas on.
Wake up! Wake up!
Who grills rice, anyway?
What's wrong?
Hang on. A child, a trampoline, and a dog. We're in for the ride of our lives. Maybe not. It's Tom Cruise in training for the London Marathon. Go, Tom! Someone keep the fans back. Still to come on your guide to You've Been Framed, teens. Cats. And all the usual violence. See you soon. Welcome back, and we pick up with teens. Perfect framed fodder, due to the high levels of hormones coursing through their veins. As this early footage of Sham 69 shows. Sometimes it's good to let the teens film themselves. And this year's must-have teenage accessory is foldy friends. When you've had enough, just fold them up, put them away, and move on. Who puts a treadmill in the corner of a room? Teens. That's who. That treadmill also massages your back. Oh, that's better.
Oh, lovely.
Yeah.
Oh,
just the spot. Uh-oh, that shelf is in a rather odd place. Sort of shelf you'd use for spices if you don't have a rack. Maybe move it into the kitchen. Go on, put yourself out for the bin men. Garden furniture, indoors. Nice. What the... Before the next Take That tour, Robbie's getting back into shape with boxer size. Jason's helping, but also settling a few old scores. The new lineup at the Sugar Babes have still got the old routine sussed. You can't improve on perfection. Hello, Dragon's Den. It's bad luck to walk under ladders, so this machine is designed to stop that by raising any ladder out of your way.
The water. This doesn't look right.
And for that reason, I'm afraid I'm out. Sport. It's just an excuse to get injured.
All my life I've been searching for something. Something never comes, never leads to nothing. Nothing satisfies, but I'm getting close. Closer to the prize at the end of the rope. All night long, I dream of the day.
Another rule, if you own a little boy, keep the camera running at all times. Eventually, they'll come through for you. Let's hear your Lulu impression. You know you make me want to shout. Mobile phone cameras are a godsend to capture those moments that would have got away a few years back, despite sometimes being less detailed than a Victorian magic lantern. Technology's changed. Cattle grids haven't. Your safety helmet counts for nothing. An average clip saved at the last moment.
Your bum hurt.
This little golfer has learned everything he knows from Tiger Woods, and the biggest lesson is this.
Knock it out.
Don't be afraid to cheat on your family.
Oh, look at that roll. Get in! Oh!
What's that, Ringo? Thomas the Tank Engine was feeling a little bit upset because his driver was asleep. That's better, said Thomas. Madonna's back garden, and security cameras catch another adoptee trying to escape. But that garden is designed to bring down anyone with thoughts of freedom or a Big Mac. Have him brought back and washed. Paddington Bear's holidays were always a little bit lonely after he lost all the hair off his face and hands.
Oh, careful, 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 careful. Oh, no, all right, Rob.
I mean, we all throw bread for ducks and swans, don't we? But a lot of them these days are ending up with a bloated feeling and would much rather have something like a cracker. Finally, working for Rick Stein's seafood restaurant isn't all glamour and scallops. Hurry up, son. Rick's due back any moment with the mayonnaise from the cash and carry. The countryside is a breeding ground, not just for wild animals, but for wild clips too. Potholers discover another one of Heather Mills' husband traps, dotted around Newcastle. Victims would stay down there until they agree to marry Heather, and only then would she send down a rope with some water. It's how she got Macca. Prince Andrew's down there somewhere.
I might set up again, yeah. You got it on video?
Campers, with the new tent glider, once you've finished at one camping site, just pack up, hang on, and head to the next. Landudno, here I come! Now, the winner of tonight's award for understatement of the show. Here it comes.
Ow.
Ow. It's blur singer Damon Albarn. He's had enough of living in the limelight, and he's off to start a new life in Panama. I'm claiming on his insurance, and then I'll meet up with him in 18 months. Foolproof. Kind of.
Didn't lean back far enough.
If only he'd leant back far enough, I'd be quids in. And here's the real thing. Canoe death faker John Darwin. His wedding. Should have given everyone a clue, really. It was a trial run. This must be one of those National Trust trampolines I hear are dotted around Britain's beauty spots. Members only.
Are you okay?
The Edge showing off to the rest of the guys in the band.
Well,
that's not
there.
The Joshua tree, is it? He still hasn't found what he's looking for. Aha! Rope bridges equal loads of money! Every year, thousands of girls apply to work at the Garnier concession in John Lewis. But with only 8 places available, they're forced to complete a series of tasks. This is to ascertain whether mascara remains applied even after soaking. Susan Boyle is big in America. Well, she's big everywhere, but afraid of flying. So she's touring the southern states by canoe. It's taking longer than scheduled. Get back in, Susan. Simon's waiting. Chainsaws, we love them. When Britney Spears hires a tree surgeon, she hires the best. Freddie Joe Baldwin of Texas comes with his own chainsaw and hat. He works at a per-tree rate and hasn't let his cataracts get in the way of business. So, what do you think, Britney?
Oh, my
my God.
Yeah, he's good, isn't he?
Oh, my God.
Get your cat on camera and eventually a framed check will be dropping through your door. It's the vet calling. Either hit the end button or find some way of pretending you're not in. Siamese cats are fiercely territorial over office chairs. Back off! Get your own chair! I'm doing my VAT. He's looking for his brother, the karate cat.
Hiya!
All right, I get the idea.
In this clip, I think the other cat on the fence calls out in a human voice. Listen. There, told you.
Ah!
It's a little known fact that cats' paws are magnetically attracted to double glazing. I've regularly got cats stuck to the sides of my conservatory like Howling Velcro. Howling Velcro. Wasn't that a blues singer? It is difficult to find the end of the paper towel roll, isn't it? Especially when it's a new roll. Good for him that he wants to clean up after himself. An over-enthusiastic ball cat. Yeah, you should really wait for the ball to go out of play before you try and grab it. That's better.
Duncan.
Duncan? That's a funny name for a cat. What's wrong with Domino?
It's a nice dog.
Ugh, dead person. In Framed, every sport is a contact sport. Broken Britain Part 2, the state of our schools. Unbelievably, this is a maths lesson. This gym sounds a buzzer every time someone looks like a prat. Coming soon to Eurosports. One-a-side kitchen football. All the excitement of the Premier League but played in a shaker-style kitchen in Stoke. Ouch! Right in the MDF. Darth Vader water skiing now. May the Force be... Oh, never mind. Isn't it annoying when you're halfway through something and you forget what you're doing? Sven Goran Eriksson there. Nice to see he's done work. That's it. You explain to her how it works. Tamara Beckwith hasn't really mastered the concept of the high jump, has she? Neither high nor a jump. Nice. I suppose this is that there kickboxing. Bit of boxing, bit of kicking. Kickboxing, as opposed to box kicking, which is just booting a cardboard box around a car park. Still, good fun. One of the lost scenes from the film Kez, in which the young lad with a love of birds of prey plays football with an off-duty traffic warden pal he met at the bingo. It's on the DVD, but Ken Loach decided to pull it after he got a black eye looking down the lens.
Sorry about that.
That's all right. When it comes to classic clips, we say thank heavens for little girls. And, of course, jetties. Jetties are great for us because they're so, well, narrow. Another graduate of Sven Goran Eriksson's vaulting class. He pumps them out. You can't park there. At the end of this clip, she seems to be suddenly possessed by the spirit of an Elizabethan gentleman. Here he comes now.
You're welcome.
We've all done it. Bought him some sort of vehicle, but couldn't be bothered to take him outside to try it out. Well, on your own head be it.
Okay.
Be creative. Try filming with no sound for that authentic Charlie Chaplin silent movie slapstick. The talkies ruined everything, especially Des O'Connor. Or add a little light music to move the video along. This was sent in by Michael Flatley. It's Rock Band for the Wii, and these two are exactly recreating Keith Moon's tenure in The Who. Spot on. Music now. If it ain't got wedding clips, it ain't you've been framed. Keep them coming.
I need love, love. I need to burn, burn. Someone call me man. And I will say, okay, here we go. You just have to burn. She said, love, don't go easy. It's a game of give and take.
No sports clips, but how many can we cram into 30 seconds? Find out soon. Welcome back. So, how many snow sport disasters did we manage to pack into 30 seconds? Let's find out together. If you got it right, stick your face in the freezer. It's cheaper. It's your guide to You've Been Framed, and here's what the adults are capable of. Ex-speaker Betty Boothroyd on a sponsored scoot across America to raise awareness of potholes. She got 300 yards from her front door. Mark Wahlberg always had a fetish for parking meters. He just loves the feel of them on his... It's got him into a lot of trouble. He left his shoes at the temple. Pete Doherty here, and he's late for his Libertines gig. And Carl's a real stickler for punctuality. Kate Moss is laughing anyway.
Richard!
She always calls him Richard to reduce press interest. We've all done it. Jumped over Zoe Ball for charity, then sprayed her with the contents of a burst beanbag. Fat Boy Slim hates it because the fine polystyrene balls get in his CD player and cost him work. Let's see it again. That's the money shot. Richard Hammond before the accident. Just checking he's put the bins out.
Yep, they're out.
You're a bit big for that swing. Try the slide.
Are you okay?
It's time for a member of Fathers for Justice to make his appearance. Well, if you haven't seen him for a while, you want to make an impression, don't you? You'll notice some of these children's faces seem to be blurred. They're actually like that in real life. It's a very rare medical condition. A little bit of E45 usually sorts it out. I'm not sure of the rules to this game, But let's hope no one wants to park their car, eh? Then came self-mail. He bought a job lot of space hoppers when Woolworths closed down and is determined to put them to good use. Music now, and let's hand the floor over to the ladies. It wouldn't be You've Been Framed without them. You better think of me. They can get you £250, too. The circus has come to town, and the clown needs to do a little work on his act.
Last time.
Release the goats. They make their own fun in the countryside. At birthday parties, kids queue up to walk the plank over the sheep dip. It's fun. And it removes ticks and lice. Everyone's a winner. Oh, dear, they've been burgled and someone's run off with the table. Shame. No proper plates and no napkins. That I can live with.
All right, you guys want to hear some Johnny Cash?
Babies are a framed staple.
Johnny Cash. Okay.
Yeah, that's right. It had the same effect in Folsom Prison.
Good job!
You can't always get Johnny Cash to come round, though. I'm guessing that's not a Disney-sanctioned Buzz Lightyear outfit. Maybe it's Buzz Lightyear when he worked for Wandsworth Council. The kids wanted to go to Thorpe Park, but instead got a mechanical horse. A mechanical horse in a bar that hasn't been decorated since 1983. It's how Anton Deck got the idea for the Jiggy Bank. Katie Holmes and Tom Cruise still deeply, deeply in love. Call the orthodontist. I know we've had trampolines already, but this one's a square one. In gymnastics, the finish is just as important as the actual routine. You have to give the crowd something memorable to go home with. So, let's see what Davey's got up his sleeve. Textbook. These two kids have based their look on 80s group Modern Romance. Although, to my knowledge, Modern Romance never did stage diving. Here we have a very silly man.
Where are you?
Well, you can see where she is. She's playing Where You Keep the Bleach. She's found a way into the sewers. Childminders, eh? You never really know what's going on, do you? The beach at Dungeness has changed a little since they built the nuclear power station. Still, the holiday was paid for, so you do what you can. But no fights, girls. Please.
No!
Or you'll ruin it. If you've captured a memorable moment on your mobile, you can upload it directly to us at itv.com/framed. It couldn't be easier getting your hands on £250 if your phone clip is used in one of our programmes. Birds have tiny brains, which make them perfect for us. This was Australia's campaign to reduce ostrich abductions. The slogan was, never accept a nut from a nutter. If the ravens leave the Tower of London, something bad is supposed to happen. Especially since the council sucked the conservatory on the back of it. Give it up, mate. You're not coming in. And there were some advantages to the floods in Tewkesbury. You no longer needed to go abroad for your holidays. A lot of the ducks followed suit.
Yeah, I think I'll stay here this year.
If you're thinking that's a funny-looking tree, you're quite right. The branches actually spell gents' toilets in Chinese. A tiny lightsaber? No, a French fried potato. Well, seagulls know it's no use eating all that fish without any chips.
Thank you.
There once was an ugly duckling who grew up to be a swan, but the swans didn't like him either, and neither did the ducks. What rotten luck. The end. If the ravens ever leave the Tower of London, bad things will happen, as outlined previously. That's why they put out these sausages. Yeah, they get through 15 strings a day. Kingfishers, however, they can leave the tower. Ah, the owl display. Not as popular as they used to be, of course. Even the owls have gone off them. And these basically fill up the owls. Nice shoes. Your holiday memories could be profitable too. Don't send us a postcard, shove us a clip. Celebrity Love Island is back. Kelly Brook tries to escape.
You okay?
Julio Iglesias now runs a bar in Mallorca. He often sings to all the girls I've loved before, but if he forgets the lyrics, he makes a quick getaway and hopes no one notices.
Jake, in the sumo tube.
I don't think it looks like a sumo suit, do you? It's more like a giant suppository. And with that image in mind...
There he goes.
That's better, thank you. John Prescott tests his old sea legs again. Yep, he's still got it. Ah, the Torbay 31. State-of-the-art in 1983, and of course a few breeze blocks and two paving slabs make an excellent front step. Later models were fitted with a door restrainer. The Torbay 32, of course. Even when on holiday in Penzance, TV's James Corden can't resist treating the crowds to his unique brand of physical comedy. He's here all summer, folks. The Karate Kid hates sun loungers, and Kung Fu kicks them whenever he gets the chance. No one knows why. Do I want clips from weddings? I do. How to Ruin a Magical Moment, Part 1.
As long as we both shall live.
As long as we both shall live. I gotta go pee-pee.
Down the corridor, first on your left. Church attendances are so low these days, people don't even bother to turn up to see their friends and relations getting married. It's just these three and the cameraman. You would have thought that the marriage of Sean Bean and Jenny Powell would have attracted more interest. Even Sean's bored of the whole thing. It's the last ever episode of Cagney and Lacey, the one where they had a civil partnership. Officer down! Yes, all right, get a room. It wouldn't be so bad, but he's not even the groom. In fact, he's not even a soldier. He's only there to hoover the stairs. Ah, thank heavens. Vanessa Feltz has finally cut her hair. Vanessa now gatecrashes Jewish weddings to stock up on matzo balls and gefilte fish. Ah, weighed down by all the matzo balls she's got stuffed up that dress. In the cream suit, it's Paul McCartney in drag. He'll do anything to try and avoid Heather.
Yeah, I'm fine, don't worry.
To save time in future, every member of Girls Aloud will get married simultaneously. Here's something that seems to be happening more and more. Wedding cake in the face. When one of these clips comes into the office, a klaxon is sounded and the lucky researcher shouts, "We got ourselves a cake in the face!" And everyone takes a day off and goes to the pub until last orders. Same with trampoline clips and rope swings. I love Sue Lawley, don't you? The way she shimmies. She never got used to fold-back speakers, though. The more extreme the sport, the more likely you are to earn some cash. The quad bike. Okay, the rider hasn't made it over the hill that separates Swaffham from nearby King's Lynn, but that doesn't mean the bike can't put on a show. Watch it go. Lovely bit of business. Viscount Linley, as you've never seen him before. Putting the snow back in Snowdon.
No way, that's amazing.
I suppose this is one way to pop a sebaceous cyst. Yuck. It's Nick Clegg to the rescue! Oh. Perhaps not. Is it a boat? Is it a bike? No, it's Brian Blessed's tongue. Get on board! Hurry, it's due in Panto in 5 minutes. Rupert Grint and Daniel Radcliffe film one of their Harry Potter films on the slopes of Swaffham. Rupert first, that's how it should be done.
Now, Daniel, that's how it should be done.
Come on, Daniel, your turn. Landing and takeoff need a bit of work. And a bit in the middle, if I'm honest. Jamie Oliver now as part of his drive to increase fitness in schools. What's that in the tree?
What?
It's the skateboard. Oh, Jamie. David Cameron experiments with another green method of travel.
Oh, are you all right?
Don't try and sound concerned, Clegg. So the trials for the replacement stick are taking place on the M25. This fella seems to be doing well. Of course, no one must ever know his identity, so I'll say nothing. All right, it's Gordon Brown, but don't tell a soul I told you. Music plus animals plus jaunty instrumental equals framed gold. We've got the kangaroo dash, the flip and flop, and the big exit. See you soon. Welcome back, and if you're dropping in on a zoo, make sure you take your camera. This clever mural of a jungle has fooled this ape. Should have gone to Specsavers. Penguin on its own treadmill now. That was a Smith song, wasn't it?
penguin on a treadmill. I know it's really serious.
Something like that, anyway. Our clips often feature a child in trouble while their parents just carry on filming and laughing. This is very much of that genre. He was finally rescued by the police 15 miles at the M62, and Mum and Dad were still laughing all the way to the bank. That mat isn't doing its job, is it? It should be abutting the threshold. But no matter. Look at the bird. Yeah, not so clever now, are you?
This camel has no head.
A camel with no head? How does he smell?
I'm not sure why he
well,
doesn't have a head.
Distinctly musky. It's actually curled round the back, love. But I know what you're getting at. I can see it. Staggering underneath. I think that's the head anyway. There it is, look. Yes. Relax, everyone. They do love a mirror birds, don't they? Oh, yes, they think it's another bird and it's a bit of company for them. It worked the same for my nan. We bought her a full-length mirror. Didn't have to visit her for a year. Next summer, why not take the family to World of Spit on Junction 4 of the M11? Exotic animals from across the world will come to your car and slowly fill it with spit. With 26 different types of saliva to collect, it's fun for everyone.
Oh, here comes a bison.
The mighty bison produces 6 litres of sputum in a minute. World of Spit. See our website for details.
Look, here, look to the left.
In today's fame-obsessed world, even gorillas are getting tired of being papped.
Talk to my agent. I'm with Avalon.
Show-offs may be annoying, but for our purposes, they're framed gold. If your teenager is exposed to more than 4 hours of Facebook a day, this is what happens to it. Sad, really.
Come on, baby. Here I am. Here I am.
Now hit your face with a book. Facebook. Get it? That mirror is a bit high, but no matter. But how resourceful is man? It's what distinguishes us from the apes. Sort of.
Oh, diddums. I fell off a chair.
Can I have a day off school, Mum? Oh, it's our old friend, the white plastic garden chair. Without that, there'd be no you've been friend.
Are you okay?
Midlands-based celebrity cook Rusty Lee. Yeah, she's not as young as she used to be, but she's still got it. Quick, Rusty. The carrots are burning. It's the dancing queen. Well, less dancing, more trotting. It's the trotting queen. You can dance. You can jive. You can trot. Ah, that shy come hither stare. Hey, fellas. Ouch. You'll get a bump on that. So amongst a running buffet of clips, we've seen pets, kids, adults, parents, outdoor action, trampolines, rope swings, falling over and water. And sometimes, just sometimes, you can have a mash-up of a few all at once. Still only 250 quid, though. How to get your clips on You've Been Framed? Well, there are so many choices.
Listen, as you keep on pushing like I need.
finish in the traditional way. Object strikes camera, freeze frame, roll credits. That's all, Framed fans. Don't forget to keep sending your tapes and DVDs to Free Post You've Been Framed, or just go to itv.com/framed, where you can upload your clips direct. Now it's even easier getting your hands on 250 quid if your clip is used in one of our programs. And don't forget to check out our website for terms and conditions. Until next time, cheerio!
The contestants have officially got more than a foot in the door as we follow them into the judges' houses in The X Factor, coming up next. And what better way to celebrate that than with the movie Happy Feet? That's coming up at 2:50, right here on ITV2.